anything. So for all of you who wanted, someone actually asked me, like, Tina, seriously speaking, what's your take on this whole side chick thing that you were talking about? So, without further ado, if you know what time it is and you want to hear my explicit thoughts on it, catch me at 4 p.m. on Sunday. I'll be on Family Unscripted and we're going to really delve, like really, really delve. Ebi ngabi chali yao. Bana Eddie Kenz, wakula chava na Uganda. What? Aha. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. So, this whole boat cruise thingy, man. I don't even know how to approach it, because you're supposed to approach it with a lot of caution, with a lot of sensitivity, and you know, with a heavy heart. And I honestly do feel, very many lives were lost, you know, and it's sad. It's a really, really sad time. Tomorrow was declared a national day of mourning. Our flags will be flying at half mast, and that they do deserve. They do deserve a day. Okay, now that we have gotten that out of the way, let's talk about this. I woke up to what I saw here with this, a full column, like a newspaper write-up, like an entire spread. Irene Namubiru has had this write-up that's been circulating on different platforms. It was on Facebook, I got it on my WhatsApp, and it's a very, very long write-up about what happened, what happened on the boat, when it happened, and all of that. And in one way than the other, it has brought on people to outrightly say certain things that we didn't expect them to say. And I do understand why people are saying what they are saying. Because for me, I was like, Irene, first of all, we didn't even know you were on that boat. If God had been in a happier mood that day and this became a scare and nobody lost their life, do you think we were going to know that you were on that boat? You snuck on and came back only to find out because, I mean, it was lights, camera, action. But we would not have known that you were on that boat. Secondly, why do I get the feeling that this is not out of a place of trauma or a place of explanation, but it is simply fastly turning into a point for you to get relevant again? Why do I feel like that? I don't feel like you're respecting the dead. I do not feel like you're respecting the lives that you are with on that boat. Because to me, honestly speaking, I'm a plain simple person. I love plain simple fact. I read, we don't care. What happened on the boat happened. What happened did happen indeed, and we do not care much for it anymore. We're trying to deal with Echidako. We're trying to see forward. We're trying to make sure every family that lost someone got their person back and they gave them a decent, respectable send-off. That is what we are caring for. But then you've come out, it's like, she has how many? It's like a part-time series, it's like a full-time series. Like, she's first given it a write-up, and then after that she's like, I'm going to post videos of what happened. Like, we don't want to know. We don't. Not now. And why, for me, this honestly feels like it is just you trying to get relevant, because lately that's all Irene has been doing. That's all you've been doing, where you jumped on board with that Ulambulene Zari. You are not on that whole situation. You are not. You are not. Wabesibako nebagamba kale jango chiringe. And you are on different social media platforms saying all these weird things. Now, I'm not attacking you. I am simply stating fact. People are still in a place of hurt. We do not care about how traumatized you are. What we care about right now is that you are safe and you are alive and you get to tell your story, not the way that you're telling it. Kalike watu wa muka sampo na utulaga ya kuyamba and how it went down. Katumala, don't give us the nitty gritty, don't give us the like, I don't want to know, I don't want to hear. Does anybody want to know? Then it went down, it's like reward. Because I suggest, either if you're trying to deal with the trauma, it's simple. Get your phone and behind Facebook and get it off social and go see you a therapist. That's what you need. You need a therapist. You don't need the whole world to be your therapy session. We cannot. We are also dealing with so much right now. We have our own problems. And we are not going to add on 2 years. 99. 99, we're on that steady flow. You get what I'm saying? And wait, is she going to upload them on Facebook too or only on YouTube? With the fact that people are actually pissed off that the Prince Wasaja was there. But I understood why he was there. He was related to the boat owner. You get what I'm saying? So he came out to support a brother, you know, and have a blast. And let's just say that Baganda are not happy bali kulopera saba saja. And do you feel they have a right? I feel they have a right. They do have a right. But then again, you don't have a right to tell someone how they party. Oh well, again, still being the bearer of bad news. Yesterday, I know most of you saw the news, one of hip hop's finest, one of Lugo Flow's, you know, people that pretty much started it all up, or was among the people that started it up. Yesterday, we lost a great person. We lost Mulekwa. And what was shocking for me is that there's a time when he was so loud and proud, you could hear about him everywhere. Then he just went silent and nobody said nothing. And then we found out when he's dead that he was actually battling throat cancer. I was shook. I was definitely shook, because in a way I expected his fellow rappers to be out there, you know. I don't know what I even expected from them. I don't. I think I saw St. Nelly said write something, like pretty much most of the fraternity has written something down for him, and it's a very sad, very, very sad thing. He was a simple cash guy, you know. He had his Ishan log and he finally lost his battle to cancer, and it's, I don't know. What's wrong with 2018? What's wrong with this year? We've lost so many young, like, we started off the year on a bad note. We lost radio. Then before we knew it, there was all these random things happening back to back, the violence, what's wrong with this year? Is the motherland tired? Is it trying to show us something? Do we need to repent? Do we need to have a sit down with Mother Earth and tell her we are sorry for all the things that we have done? Please, Kakana. I don't know, it's just too much. Very many lives are being lost and it's sad. You know, so let's offer up a moment of silence and a prayer for his family and, of course, for his departed soul. It's a sad day. It was a sad day. It's still a sad day. Bana, Talafia, Mafia. I've done two stories on you back to back in days. So, apparently, Fit for Maker is being sued by a guy called something Bees Beans. Chidem? Chini Bean, is it? Cheese Bees. First off, Cheese Bees. Chin Bees. With a name like that, you're never going to be a star. Let me start from there. Anyway, he is suing. Which song is it? Because for me, they're saying, it is suing Sambu Fika Benyimba Zabane na Zikola Mwebibye. But which one of you people didn't know from the jump that Fit for Maker doesn't have a beat that is his? Abanga music kubada. He's just one of those guys who copies and pastes. Chijemu luzungu chiteke muluganda. It's that simple. Why would you even? Why? Anyway, Chini Bees. Oh, God. Chini Bees is suing Fik for Maker, and I want to hear what Fik for Maker has to say. What is Fik for Maker saying? Because according to Fik, he's going to say, no, it's not his song, it's my song. But this guy, Alimed Deko, it's been going on for a minute. Anyway. You see, that is what happens when the industry lacks originality. That is what happens when we so eagerly and quickly accept bubblegum music around us. We get people like Chini Beans and Bees or something, whatever his name is, and Fit for Maker. That's what we have gotten ourselves into, people. So enjoy the circus, enjoy the drama. I won't be. And on that note, kambasibule no basibula. @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and @TinaFierce1. On Instagram, it's @TinaFierce1 with an H. I'm so pumped. So pumped. Christmas is along the way. I'm finna do carols. I'm finna get gifts. I'm finna have a good Christmas this year. I just want it to be magical. And I hope for all of you out there, that's the same wish you have. Let's just, I don't know. Anywho, I'm out.